this is our party and this is our country. And the reason we threw this party was for you. So before we do anything else, thank me, thank Jeff, but also thank the host committee members and the contributor people, because the tickets are definitely, we're not making any money off of this. So I would like to thank people who were the host committee and the contributors. So if you are. Living well is the best revenge. So, in planning this party, when I was talking to Jeff, the drama we dealt with, you know, if you think I'm a drama monger on Twitter, like, that was 10% of it. There's 90%. And then I said, you know, we got to get our mindset right. We're going to allow people, we're going to have the hottest party, we're going to make everyone jealous. People were messaging me every day, hundreds of people, Mike, how do I get involved? Mike, how do I knock the doors? Mike, I go, I'm not involved in the campaign. I mean, come on, I want to be a controversial guy. I don't want anything I say, translate to them. I don't know anything. So I was talking to Jeff, and I was kind of complaining. I was like, why are these people messaging me? He goes, Mike, what's wrong with you? What do you mean? Because you know how many people would kill to have that kind of problem? So we started our hashtags, we ran Twitter, we got everybody involved, we registered 3 people to vote, we won 3 people to get the polls, we got 3 articles on social media pushed out there, and we kind of ran it, which is right. But life is about momentum, and we all felt after the election, as the transition stuff happened, the momentum changed, right? It shifted a little bit. Everybody went from hyped and excited to, like, now what do we do? So we thought we would just have a party and we'll reclaim Hillary Clinton, the bigoted Nazi's language. Yeah, she wanted to put us in camps, which that doesn't sound like the thing Trump does. Hillary's the one who wants camps for us. because the polls are on New Year's resolution.
Fake news!
If you don't feel it in your heart, if you don't feel it in your soul, it's not gonna happen. And nobody, apparently because the fake news media, I follow them. Here's what I learned at the DNC, the RNC in general. They project, they would never leave Twitter. I go, well, wait a minute, bro. I was at the RNC and I watched you go into the air conditioner. Well, I'm out with the people. At the DNC, I even marched with the filthy, you know, I don't want to call it that. We're unified people. I marched with the protesters at the DNC. Where was the fake news media? Where was the New York Times? Where was the Washington Post? They weren't there. They weren't there. Screencasts and tweets. So-and-so said something on Twitter. Let's make news. Let's talk about Twitter. Let's not talk about people. When we talk to people, that's why I knew something went. So right now, remember this is your party. Remember the way that you're okay. Leave your friend. You're meeting new friends tonight. Amazing that I met with the election cycle. So, my tip, the drama you deal with is always going to have an upside. The big upside for me is meeting Jeff Deasy. So, I met Jeff at the Gates for Trump party in the RNC. We started talking more. And I realized that more people who had never been involved in politics, they were in, and he was all in. So this party, he made it happen. So I'd like to welcome to this stage, Jeff Deasy.
Thank you.
only lost in Western countries. Davos football is in recent years, we've seen a confirmation of this. Nowhere is this more apparent than the migrant crisis in Europe. The most important of us got that separate gay rights, women's rights, and very identities.
But most of the night!
Good, too.
We feel this here in America, too, with the excesses of political correctness and globalism. Taken too far, these forces are leading us to social fragmentation, growing inequality, and almost Maoist sense of social justice sanctimony. Yeah. We and the rest of the West need an alternative to navigate the complex challenges of the 21st century. We need an alternative that is practical, moral, and common sense. And yeah, it is Trump. Yeah. Preserve our civilization while embracing the future. It's based on three core principles: sovereignty, and by this we mean enforcing borders, self-determination, and stronger sense of national identity and shared values; economic nationalism, by this we mean focusing on the middle American, focusing on the working middle-class Americans, not just the top 1%. And there's a fourth principle, is resistance to cultural Marxism and the excesses of Let's be very clear that we do not want Trump to be George W. Bush 2.0. Social security reform, but those issues aren't what define us. The question I often think about is how can we preserve our civilization in a way that's practical, moral, and forward-looking. I think my grandmother, who came to the U.S. from Mexico as a child in the 20s, her family. My mom is a Mexican citizen. She actually does want to build walls. Side of my family was presiding over the Bohemian Club in San Francisco. Western ideals. In many ways, the challenge of the 21st century is to reconcile these two sides of ourselves, our Anglo-Western heritage and our immigrant multiracial one. It's kind of awkward and messy, but I believe we can reconcile these forces. And I believe that we can do so in a way that works for all Americans. I don't pretend to have all the answers, but I am here to talk. America, this is our make it work moment. We in this room want to be constructive. Our hearts are full. We are not going away. We are determined to make America great again for all Americans.
My friend on
the
internet.
tonight, and I'm gonna let Lucian say a couple words.
So we've had what? 8 miserable years of the best 80 times that I'm ready to jerk off to our president. And so we've been in contact with the new administration.
We've been in contact with, as you know, the Gay Rape Pundit. I'm based out of St. Louis, Missouri. Woo! During the election, I have 1 million readers a day. And the reason was because I was telling the truth, and the major news was telling the fake fucking news. They're going to do some things different, and we've got the word that the Gay Rape Pundit is going to have a White House correspondent. Correspondent Lucian Wintrich to bring you the real news.
Donald Trump is not the president
of the United States as of noon tomorrow without you. He knows that, and I know that. Donald Trump came to me after the primary, and he said, Sheriff, I need your help. I want your support.
Amen.
And I said, you got it.
Amen. Thank you.
And I said, Mr. Trump, I don't know where you think I can help you, but let me give you some advice. Don't say that a lot to Donald Trump, right? And I mean that in a good way. A smart man, but I said, I'm a fighter. Put me in the trenches.
Yeah.
I play smash, bump, pump. What to do with me. Get tired of your day, folks. Nothing works. Nothing works. And here's why nothing works. Because I knew as I traveled the country on behalf of Donald Trump and the Make America Great Again campaign, I knew that I had the support of you. On behalf of Donald Trump, and everywhere I went, I said, I told Mr. Trump, I'm going to do everything I can to help you become the 45th president of the United States. And there's been some ups and downs, right? It's been an emotional roller coaster that I'll be real honest with you, I'm exhausted about.
Good job, brother.
But we never quit, did we?
No!
And now the real fight begins.
Drain that swamp!
Because if you know the left like I do, if you know liberals like I do, they never quit. And the beat is not in their vocabulary. And they're going to do everything they can. I walked through the damn door out front and eggs were being hurled. At D.C.'s finest.
Yeah, how about
D.C. police officers were up. Side, making sure we can hold this event in here.
Trump!
I love you. I really do.
I love you.
Being my inspiration as the left was
awesome.
Throwing everything they had at me.
Greatness.
You are my inspiration. And you'll continue to be my inspiration. So enjoy this night. Let's help Donald Trump make America great again.
We got music, we have art, we have more banter. What do you want? Real quick before we move into any kind of music, we have a special guest. He ran in primary against Punk Rock, Paul Ryan. So we're going to ask him. He wants to say hi to the crowd. He wants to say hi to the crowd. So come on.
I had a 0.3% chance of winning, and I ran anyhow. I ran because Trans-Pacific Partnership would have eliminated all your jobs. And they would have given your jobs to foreigners, and that's wrong. And that's what Paul Ryan worked on behalf of. So everybody here in this room who worked hard for Donald Trump, you keep working. You keep doing what you're doing. I know Kelly Ward's in this audience somewhere here tonight. She's running against Jeff Flake. God bless you for all your support.
I don't know. I can't hear all of
that. And thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
And now for Music of the Week. This is the wonderful Tanyama. She's performed this from Ron Paul again. She's a fellow freedom fighter. Great musician, and you're gonna be playing all night tonight, isn't that right? In the room.
Hey everybody.
So
happy to see you all today.
Thank you.